headquarters for Goli Traditional Airport. And we want to say, officially, we are handing over the flag of Mossop to you. That we know you have resumed your office, but continue. May this flag continue to fly. Don't care anybody. We're going to go out behind you. Thank you.
Thank you. When you are going, when you are going, when you are going, baby, 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 baby,
baby, baby, baby, baby, baby,
Before we begin, today we are gathered in Buri, and I want to thank the Buri National Territory for hosting this rally. Today I want to address you on two things, which is the reason why we have called this rally. The first is peace in Ogoniland. The first is for peace in Ogoniland. And the second is the way forward to address this Ogoni problem. I will speak on peace in Ogoniland, not just as president of Mossop, but as a prince of the dynasty of Berisako. Many people do not know that I am the descendant of Beneba, the 11th son of Berisako. And it is upon that that I'm going to be speaking to you today. I'm speaking directly to the youths of Ogoni. I want all of you to listen to me. We have had in the past few days, lots of killings all over Ogoni. We heard about killings in Peru recently. We had the case of Lewin and Bono. All of these things are crimes that is coming from our youth. Today, I want to tell you, it should stop. I am saying that this whole thing should stop. I'm speaking as president of Mossop, and I want you to hear me. All the killings and shootings and all of the nonsense that we've been hearing, we are saying it should stop. This land, Ogoni, is crying for just one thing. One thing, justice. Ogoni is crying for justice. Ogoni is not seeking any blood. I will remind you of what Ken said when we launched the Ogoni struggle. He said, in trying to recover the money that have been taken away from our land, our lives that have been deprived of, he said, we do not want any Ogoni life lost. Not an Ogoni life, not of the strangers amongst us. We must make sure that our struggle, Ogoni struggle, remains peaceful, it must remain non-violent, and it is that non-violence that will bring victory. It is not the gun. We must drop that gun. Are you hearing me? Yes. God said, those who kill by the gun also do what? Die by the gun. Not so? If you are thinking that arms struggle will deliver a body, you are missing it. Arms struggle will not deliver a body. We want peace in a body. And from this day henceforth, I am calling you to use every one of you, drop the gun. The politicians that are sponsoring these things, they do not have their children, they do not have their families shooting this gun. They give you money, they shoot gun, and then you go ahead and do that and destroy your land. We do not have another Ogoni. and we cannot afford to destroy this one that we have. Let me leave there. And I'll go to the second issue, which is critical. The issue of how we resolve this Ogoni problem. I told you before, I said, Ogoni land is seeking for one thing. That one thing is justice. That one thing is freedom. That one thing is our rights to be respected by the Nigerian state. That is what this land is seeking. And we must, as a people, stand up to say, we insist that our rights should be respected. We cannot, as Nigerians, we cannot be contributing so much to the Nigerian economy and we are getting nothing. Let me tell you, they deceive us. They tell us that all resumption will create jobs. It's a lie. All resumption does not create jobs. The oil is drilled and it's mechanical. The thing just flows from here to Boni, and from Boni it is sold, and the money goes to a federation account. And of course, we don't have a state called an Ogoni state. So when they share money from the federation account among the Nigerian states, we get nothing. And that is why we are saying it is unjust, it is unfair. And we are insisting on our own. Our own must also be given to us. Because we are producing. And so, we are giving the government the opportunity to talk. We are willing to talk. Ogoni is willing to sit down with the government and let us discuss what the problem is. And then, when we agree, it is based on that agreement that we can move forward. It is based on the agreement that we have that we can say, okay, all resumption can now continue. Ken Saroua said, he does not expect all resumption in Ogoni to commence until it is properly negotiated. Not just negotiated, though, properly negotiated. That proper negotiation means that we must accept the terms of the negotiation and we must say yes, we accept this one. When we do, then you will see that this whole thing will flow. We cannot talk about oil resumption in a situation where the things that brought about the conflict, the things that created the conflict has not been addressed. Ogoni is not in trouble today because we wanted just a clean up. For God's sake, if it had been cleaned up, they will not have died. They will have cleaned and asked, is there somewhere else you want us to clean? They will have cleaned everything. It is not just about the cleanup, but it is the fundamental issue of our resources being taken away, our land being taken away from us, our world also being taken away from us, and we have lost everything, nothing is being given to us. That is part of, in fact, that was the fundamental reason why Musa was launched. Musa was not launched to be in Abuja. Musa was not launched to be jumping from one vehicle to the other with high pressure. Musa was launched to protect the interests of Ogoni people. If you read the Ogoni Bill of Rights, it says, we mandate the movement for the survival of the Ogoni people to make representations for as long as these injustices continue. That is the mandate of Musa. As long as they continue to cheat us, as long as they continue to deprive us what belongs to us, as long as they continue to take away our resources from our land and give us nothing, the mandate of Musa is to protest these injustices. And that is what we are doing. And when they agree, or when they decide that yes, we can take our own share as the owners of the land, these issues will be resolved. That is where we stand. And I want you to take home today, Musa is not divided. Musa is one, and that is the Musa that is here today. And Musa will continue to protest the injustices that have been done to Ogoni land. No matter how much share we sponsor legalism against us, no matter how much share we sponsor terror in Ogoni land, no matter how much share we try to crush us with the military or whatever, Musa will not submit. We will not submit to oppression. We will not submit to any form of intimidation. And we will not leave Ogoni land as well. Thank you very much. God bless all of you.